Welcome to Laguna Seca Raceway. As you can see, the track is empty. Unfortunately, today they're still trying to prepare for the next season. That's at least what they told me in the shop. I'm going to give a couple of pointers here to give like an idea where you are on the track. So over there, that's like the start-finish line. Way up there, and then you go downhill, and that's like the really difficult first. It's not a corkscrew, it's a hairpin corner. So there's the hairpin corner, you come around it, then you go there to the right, all the way there over the curbs, and you just accelerate all the way down here across the curbs here. Go all the way up here, and that's where you most of the time have to brake really hard before the corner, and then you go in a corner that goes uphill, so you can make up a lot of for the braking point there, and then accelerating out of there is really difficult. And then you go just around the hill here, so hopefully I will be able to get up there. About that. Right. So that proved to be a bit more difficult than I thought, because what is behind me is a big gate, so you cannot pass that. So here's the corner where you have to brake really hard, get out of the corner, get uphill. I'll walk over here. So that would also be a very nice illustration. So maybe I can walk along this path, and I have to park my car first. So you come uphill here, then you have a sharp corner that way. You don't have to brake here, you just let go of the gas and immediately step on it again. So I haven't been able to get there yet because I had to park the car somewhere, but here you can see what the difference in height is. If you drive this in, like, let's say, Gran Turismo, it's slightly different than in reality. It's just amazing. If you just look at the difference between the height over there, then right around there it starts to get steep, and it gets flat again, and then all of a sudden you go uphill steeply. It's just amazing. Now I'll try to go around all the way up there and take some pictures of the, or make a video of the course. So this is another angle that you take the out of the corner. You get here, and then basically you let go of the throttle over there. You take the inside, you take the outside, and you just accelerate all the way to the top of the hill. There's the lookout point where it just was. Now we're going to head that way. Feel a bit like Alexa Smith from Noriaro when he did the Ebisu tour. And now I have great respect for him because it's really hard. because you have to walk a lot. You show a lot of things. So we're going uphill over here. All the way up. Almost there. Oh, this is steep. Oh man, this is just amazing. So, if you just look how steep this is. In Gran Turismo, you don't really notice at all. You don't notice at all. You know that it's going a bit uphill, but not this steep. I can see better the stages where people can sit. It goes uphill, downhill, into the hairpin. You accelerate out of there, you come here, here, and then all the way around here. So I'm almost at the top. We're here at the top. We made it to the corkscrew. So, once you come up the hill, you will be having a lot of speed. You have to brake before the top of the hill. Otherwise you don't have enough traction if you go over the hill. Brake all the way up there, let go, go into the corkscrew that starts right here. Let's see if we can take a couple of minutes there as well. Get a good view here on the corkscrew. You go around the corner and then all of a sudden there's a deep drop in height, so you will lose traction while cornering and you have to go the other way around. So you have to take the inside of the corkscrew, which is really difficult because you need to get around the bend and take the inside. And especially in Gran Turismo, this is one of the hardest parts. Well, in the race it isn't. You just jump over it and you just pray that you will land fine. But like in the license videos, or license videos, in the license trials, you have to take this corkscrew the correct way. So that's a really difficult, really difficult one. And unfortunately I am, oh wow, just look at the squirrel over there. Squirrels! Oh wait, I'm just like a dog. What? Squirrels? Anyway, so you can see there, and then the drop going all the way there, all the way down. Just amazing how the height difference is, like mind-blowing. That's like 4 or 5 stories in height. No, more than that. Yes. Okay. Let's see if we can also cover the backside of the circuit. As I'm just starting to enjoy myself walking around this track. So once you get out of the corkscrew, you can step on the pedal there, and you can basically accelerate out of there, go into the corner, let go, let the corner take care of it, and they're a bit banked, just like the American highway off ramps. They're banked, so you can take them with a bit more speed than usual. You will get around there, and then you should come back to the circuit right here. Yes. So there we are. Once out of that corner, you will get back to this side. There's another banked corner, which you can accelerate out of. Then there's the entrance of the pit lane. Don't take that one. You go all the way there. And then there's a hairpin just right before the start finish, and then you go again your next round all the way down there. So guys, that's Laguna de Seca. I'm exhausted. I had such a long walk. Must have been between all the cuts and all the speed ups that I'll probably do, must have been at least 40 minutes to get around here. So I hope you enjoyed it. Just one remark, if you would ever visit Circa, I would say this is the best spot to be in. You should have a nice overview here over the front of the circuit. And then the back of the circuit, you can just turn around, you can see people go into the corkscrew. This has to be like the best spot. If I look at this spot, how it's composed of, I would say a lot of people. So let's head back to the car, and I'm out of here. Thank you for watching. Thank you for sticking around, because it's probably going to be a lengthy video. And hope to see you next time.